George, can I help you? Oh, I'm sorry, I must have bumped it. You know, you said to them, here's your calling. Now, if you need me, push the button. I'll come down and help you. So at that point, you gave a commitment. You gave a promise. I'll come down. You push it. You need me, I'll come. Well, 9 o'clock, 9:30 at night, 10 o'clock at night, get quiet, get kind of scary. You know, am I the only person left on the planet? You know, I need human contact. They just push the light and you come down and, okay, I'm not alone. There are people out there. So if I really do need them, if something really does happen, you know, they really will come and help me. So at that point, they were basically just testing you. Height and weight, of course. Now, if they can stand the course, we're basically going to use a scale like what you've seen in the doctor's office. When we've been back to the lab, that you basically seen that, okay? And you probably know how to do it. It's got your larger bar at the bottom and your slider bar on top. Most of our folks that are coming into the nursing home now, though, are extremely weaker. The people that are coming in now are much sicker, much weaker than what came into our nursing homes 10 or 15 years ago. Most of them are going to be wheelchair bound, okay? Well, basically on 145, you can see the wheelchair scale, where basically the person just wheels up on the scale and we weigh them. Then, of course, the wheelchair has to be weighed, and then the two subtracted.
Oh, so you do that, it's not set?
No. You got to weigh the wheelchair. And sometimes if the wheelchair belongs to the nursing home, they'll weigh it one time and put a tag on it. This wheelchair weighs 45.5 pounds. So a lot of times, you know, if it's not been weighed, if it's their personal one, then yeah, you got to come back and weigh them. The platform scales or the wheelchair scales are really nice to use. We had these chair scales in which we had to transfer the person out of their wheelchair into a chair scale, and they sat in the chair, and then we had to get their weight. And of course, that meant two more extra transfers. So as you know, we're talking about adding to our Volkswagen weight here a little bit, you know? And of course, like I said, we're getting the sicker, more injured, debilitated, weaker people in than we used to get 10, 20 years ago. So the more lifting, the more wear and tear on them. So, but those transfer scales do work great, those wheelchair scales. Now, if they can stand like on 146, that's how we're gonna get their height. Most of our people, again, can't stand. And what we can basically do is when they're laying in bed, like it shows you on 147, just virtually get their height with like a tape measure from the back top of their head just all the way down like what she did or he did to their bottom of their foot. Now, if they have a curved back, if they have contractures, like let's just say, you know, they're laying in bed like this and this leg here is contractured like this or both legs are, you know, in that case, we cannot take the tape measure straight down the body. You know, I had somebody do that one day and they came back and told me somebody's 4'6". You know, what we have to do is put the tape measure, you know, we've got to roll them on their side, take the tape measure, put it the back of their head, not up here, but the back, you know, because we've put it right here, we've added that much to their height. But right back here, and then we go down the spine, right down the middle, around the buttocks, behind the leg here to the back of the knee, and then, like she has in the picture there, down to their heel. And then, of course, we have a truer height. Now, for the most part, you're just gonna get the height once on admission, but weights have to be repeated.
How often do they have to do this?
Normally, once a month. Now, if they're having weight problems to gain or lose weight, you may do them as frequently as once a week. Now, if they've got congestive heart failure and fluid overload and fluid retention is a real issue for us, For those people, you actually may do once a day. Because if those people are to gain, say, 3 pounds in one day, well, that 3 pounds